Resurrection. That's right, she's back as the intrepid Ripley, which might astonish those who remember that in Alien 3 she was left comprehensively dead. Still, why let a little matter like death stand in the way of a money-making franchise? Hollywood has the technology, it can rebuild her. So it did. Last week in London, I talked to Ms. Weaver about the new film.
Who are you?
Ripley Ellen, Lieutenant First Class, number 36706.
Ellen Ripley died 200 years ago.
What is that?
It occurs to me that you must have been as surprised as anyone by the resurrection of Ripley.
Well, that's exactly true. I had died quite sincerely and was very happy being dead. I really felt we'd made three wonderful films, and that was enough. They sent me the script, finished. Winona was already attached. I was sort of the last element besides the director, and I was very... very intrigued by the script. It was very provocative. It brought Ripley back so that she wasn't really the same Ripley, sort of trying to save the day. She was sort of this anti-Ripley. There have been mistakes in the cloning process, so she has other attributes that we find out about, and she's had a sort of genetic mix with the alien, and throughout the picture there's this unease about how much she is of which and where her loyalties lie. Essentially, it was playing a sort of much more raw sort of animal character.
There's one first, must be a first, and that is an underwater fight scene in space. I've never seen that.
Yes. Oh, that was so terrifying.
It looked kind of terrifying.
Yeah, I think my hair was standing on end, but you couldn't tell because it was wet. It was really the hardest physical sequence I've ever had to do as an actor. And we were underneath for about 3 weeks. It was the first major sequence we shot as an ensemble, so it was a very interesting way of getting to know each other. Excuse me, your boot was in my face, and I know it wasn't on purpose, but you know, let's work this out, sort of thing.
Well, Jean-Pierre Jeunet is quite an interesting choice, isn't he? He's done nothing in America before, has he?
No.
I mean, probably best known for Delicatessen, I suppose, in this country.
Well, he was quite remarkable, actually. He loved the alien pictures. And again, he was not at all intimidated. He thought he would be crazy not to do it, and I know it was very difficult for him suddenly working in the studio situation, but I think it all actually worked very well.
Action. Action.
Each time they get to work with young, mad... genius director, and I think that's why the series remains as provocative as it is.
And also, you've got Winona Ryder in this one,
and
she's very good too.
Yes.
Have you worked with her before?
I hadn't, actually. It was one of the great draws to me, was to work with Winona, who apparently had a poster of Ripley over her bed when she was 8 or something. You know, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's like a huge fan of the Alien series.
Well... you gonna kill me or what? There's no point, is there? They've taken it out of you. Where is it? Is it on the ship? You mean my baby?
You're very tall. You're 5'11", aren't you? And you work in an industry entirely dominated by very short men. Now, does your height work for or against you?
Actually, I read an article on the plane that said that tall women were very popular in Hollywood, that it was the chic thing to be in, listed a lot of tall actresses. I was not one of them. But if that's great, I think it's just, again, the sort of idea that powerful women are worth watching.
As it turned out, it's the only action series with a woman star, isn't it? I mean, that must be an attraction to an actress, surely.
Well, I think it's, like, incredible luck. It also, you know, the success of The Alien every few years allows me to do a lot of other smaller independent films. So it's been a wonderful thing for me.
Is there likely to be an Alien 5?
I think we're not going to do any more than 39, and we're going to stop.
Only 39? Yeah. Is this a firm promise?
I promise.
I mean, I take this away.
Absolutely.
So what is the Alien franchise going to help you to promote next?
Well, actually, I'm doing a film with Peter Cattaneo called Dear Rosie, which we hope to do next year. And I'm also doing another movie written by Rafael Yglesias, who did Death and the Maiden. Mm. And I'm doing, actually, two romantic comedies.
Wow.
So that'll be a nice change.
So it's going to be another 3 or 4 years before Alien 5.
Hope so.
I'll be reviewing Alien Resurrection next week. And early in the new year, Sigourney Weaver pops up again, co-starring with Kevin Kline in a very different film.